Remember A.A. Milne and his wonderful character, Christopher Robin? He said, "You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think." Yeah. And Wayne Dyer said it in a way that just so typifies the science of mind teaching. He said, "You cannot always control what goes on outside, but you can always control what goes on inside." So how about this? How about for the week ahead, the weeks ahead? Every time we hear something about the virus, every time we hear that word, what if we said to ourselves, just inside, in a very quiet, prayerful way, "The healing is already here. The healing is already here." Because if we say it's going to take 6 months, it's going to take a year, it will take 6 months, it will take a year. So let's know there is as much God present, as much divine intelligence and wisdom available to people who are doing research and doing good work right now as there will ever be. And if we have a collective agreement that the healing can come forward right now, in fact, it can. So every time you hear the word virus, silently say to yourself, "The healing is here. The healing is here." And we'll see what happens. We have a lot to be grateful for. I hope you will join me in prayer right now. So we turn our attention inward for this moment, recognizing that we are surrounded and filled with God's infinite, loving, intelligent spirit, that God is a principle of love itself, and that love is who and what each and every one of us is. So I know we are surrounded and filled with God's loving, healing light, and nothing unlike this can come unto us. We could not be separate from God, from good, from life. And so we include in our prayer today our family members and friends, our parents and children, all of those that we love and hold near and dear. We see them in our mind's eye, and we wrap our spiritual arms around them, knowing that God is fully present right where they are, that they are guided by wisdom, that they are healed in God's perfect love, and that they have the consciousness of upliftment and renewal and forward movement. We let our prayer be a blessing that enfolds our entire globe and everyone on it. So we claim perfect healing for each and every person affected by this appearance of virus. We know that the principle of God is so much greater than all of this. And that's what we turn to now as we turn to that principle, power, and presence again and again and again. And so we bless our church. We bless all churches everywhere. We bless synagogues and temples and mosques and ashrams, all paths to God. And I'm certain that we are blessed by being together today, that there is raising up for all of us. And so with an open, gracious, full heart, I say thank you, God. Thank you for a truth that makes us free. Thank you that we live in a place where we can practice this teaching freely, safely, lovingly. Thank you for the good that continues to pour into our lives. And so with a full heart, I just release this word. I know it's done. And so it is. Together we all say, amen.